In this video, I'll show you how to add dimensions that relate to threaded holes, external threads, as well as counterbores. So we have kind of an interesting part here. I've got two counterboard holes, I have four internal thread holes, and I've got one external thread there. So we'll use smart dimensions. Let's start with these counterbores. So just go ahead and use your standard dimension, and then we'll go in here and edit it. So what we're going to show is the format is, let's just delete that, that we're going to first call out the through hole, and in this case that's 0.4. Make sure you put the diameter symbol in front of that. Oh, and we also have two of these, so we'll put a 2x in front. Let's make a make two lines on this. So the first line will call out the through hole diameter. Then next one's going to call out the counterbore diameter, so use the counterbore symbol, then the diameter symbol, and then the diameter of the counterboard hole, which is 0.625. Then put a space, and then put the depth symbol, and that's going to call out the depth of the counterboard itself. So it looks like that. And then you can move it around as you need. For internal threads, so for these holes right here, software's pretty smart, and it recognizes that those are threaded holes, and that's the perfect call out, with the exception of we have four of them. So put your cursor in front of there and put a 4x and a space, call out those. Now obviously you're going to have to do the location dimensions on all these features as well. I just want to show you the specifics of those. For this external thread, and you can call that in either view. I think I'll use this top view since I have those other dimensions on there. Just use the note. Click on that kind of the outer edge of the threads and click at a point, and then basically just type in what you want to say. In this case, we have a half 13. So you put half dash 13. And then UNC, and that's the call out. You don't call out the diameter, that number right there, the half inch, that's your major diameter, so you do not need to call out the diameter. Now for the length of the thread, that's something different. We want to call out the length of the thread. You could do that like that. Also a chamfer. So we have a chamfered end on that. You always, on an external thread, you always chamfer that to make it easier to start the bolt. If you go up to Smart Dimension and click on this little arrow, you have a tool specifically designed for chamfers. And what you're going to do is click on the angled edge and then either the horizontal or vertical edge, and that'll be your note. So that's simple enough. Okay, so again, you still need locations on these features, but at least that's how you call out the specific numerical values for those.